It's been a while since I've talked about it. Maybe it's time to cooperate. I need some help to forget about it.
Beebadoobee, hello.
Hello, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you. I want to say congratulations. Your hit, Deathbed Coffee for Your Head, has been absolutely great for me. Like, I hear it and it makes me happy. How did you feel when you realized you really sort of went viral on TikTok?
It was really strange. Obviously, I had no involvement in that collaboration. I was just sampled. I wrote that song 2 years ago, so it was the first song I ever wrote. One of my purest forms of creation. So it being sampled and for that many people to listen to it was like really overwhelming and actually quite scary for me because I'm not really used to this much attention. But, you know, I think it's such an amazing thing where people can listen to that song and discover my music through it. But I think it's super cool and I'm extremely grateful for Popu who had done the sample and for it being as successful as it is today. So
your song Care has been on replay for me for like all day since yesterday and probably for the rest of the foreseeable future as well. Am I saying this right? It's like an angsty anthem that girls consider rock out to.
Yeah, definitely.
Okay, the other vibe that I got from the song and from the video is it's really quite 90s. Was that a vibe you were going for? Or is that just Beebadoobee?
I don't think it was a vibe that I was like, this album has to be super 90s. I feel like that's just the type of music I listen to. And from that, it like slides its way subconsciously within my music. Sometimes I do it without realizing. Sometimes I literally write a song that sounds exactly like a song from that era. And I'm like, I cannot use this song because it is a genuine ripoff. Because right. It's like, it just happens without me realizing. I feel like I grew up with that sort of stuff. You know, my mom showed me that sort of stuff. So it just happens quite naturally. And I find that time so interesting. I feel like the music resonates to me so much, like, you know, Vance to Veruca Salt to Alanis Morissette, you know, to Pavement, to Sonic Youth. I just think it's such an iconic era of music. So
did you listen to like the Britney Spears and the Backstreet Boys and any of those boy band type things when you
Not really. I feel like when I grew up, it was definitely, I remember my first ever cover was Britney Spears when I was like 7. I was obsessed with her when I was a girl, when I was a little girl. But yeah, I guess like right now, I feel like the whole of But I'm a Cheerleader soundtrack is just all these amazing front women bands just rocking out. And there's a song called Kevin is Gay by Giant Drag, which is literally my anthem right now. And, you know, it goes from that to Dinosaur Jr. to, you know, My Bloody Valentine. It's just super cool. It's a great era.
YouTube made you, and you posted about this as well, the first artist on the rise for 2020. Congratulations.
Thank you.
And because of that, we're going to switch things up just a tad, and we're going to be playing a bunch of firsts. When this whole COVID-19 is over, what's the first thing you're going to do?
Probably go away with my boyfriend to like a hot country or something and just like spend a week there. Go to Paris maybe with him. I just want to go away with him.
Now, do you remember your first fear?
I had a thing about beards when I was younger. I used to be terrified of mustaches. Yeah. Weird, right? When I was growing up, for some reason, I was terrified of men who had like a beard. I thought it was really scary.
Like, do you still catch yourself in moments going, oh, that could scare me? Or is that?
Not really. I'm like, because my boyfriend has like stubble and I think it's quite hot now. So yeah, I'm just like, why did I ever think of differently?
First big influence in your life?
Probably Kimye Dawson and Elliot Smith. Two of my favorite musical artists. I just love the way they songwrite and their melodies, and I think the honesty within their lyrics is so, it's just so nice and amazing to me. So,
and still till today, right?
Oh, still today. Yeah, I've still got an Elliot Smith tattoo. EXO, it's on here. That's my favorite album.
Nice.
And that's Daniel Johnson, my other inspiration, who inspired me a lot.
And I saw the bee, of course.
Oh yeah, the bee, the bumblebee.
Do you remember your first secret talent when you discovered one?
Writing loads of stories. I used to like get awards for writing in creative writing because I used to write like poems and stories growing up. So this bad boy right here. They filled. It has like every, I've had journals throughout my whole like teenage life. So there's like a really sad one. There's like one when I met my boyfriend, it was like really exciting. There's this one where it's just me now. So
now, if you've got a vision board of the people you'd love to collaborate with, anyone around the world, who would be first on that list?
Mickey from Lush, from this band Lush. She's super cool. I played Latitude Festival and I saw like a few months later she had posted about me saying that she saw me live and she thought it was really good. And I was like, so I was like, oh my god, you're like my idol, thanks.
If you've got to summarize your life right now in a quote or in a song lyric or, you know, a sentence, what's the first thing that pops into your head?
Very strange. Unexpected, yeah. Very strange and unexpected.
Very strange. So that could be it. Life is very strange and unexpected.
Yeah, pretty much.
I just had one random question that popped into my head.
Mm-hmm.
What would you be doing if you weren't Beebadoobee the singer all around the world?
I mean, it's just I've always wanted to be an nursery teacher when I grew up, and I did like teacher assisting for like a year and I thought that was really fun. So, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Could that still happen?
Oh, yeah. It's definitely going to happen in the future.
Thank you very much for your time.
Thank you for having me.
Great rest of the year, and please come to Singapore.
Of course, man, I'd love to.
So otherwise, we'll see you soon in Singapore. We'll chat soon.
Bye.
Same, are you the same? Are you?